guys, your idea is already recorded in our last session, right? So you don't need to completely go through your idea again. You can just briefly tell your idea, and then you can actually focus on whatever you have done. Because you already have video of the idea.
So the idea for our application today is to let users inform whoever they want about where they are and what kind of environment they are in without their interaction. They need not initiate any operation like something like Twitter, where you're updating yourself where you are in, you're checking in Facebook. So something like that need not be required, right, from the user's part. With the amount of sensors we have, we can always get that data. So that's what we are trying to achieve. We are using a couple of modules here. One is this small sensor device, which is it's a temperature reader, humidity, altitude, accelerometer, gyroscope, parameters, etc., etc. Right. So this one is going to give us some information that no smartphone can give, which is temperature, humidity, and altitude. And this information we make use of it to identify what kind of environment the user is in. Another one is we've taken this Nexus device. This one actually uses Bluetooth Low Energy, which is supported by this device only, and this device needs to be rooted, so which we have done today after coming here. So that to unlock the Bluetooth Low Energy module. And another one is this apparatus, which we'll be explaining later anyway. So this one is used for displaying a small tooltip information for any user if necessary, right? Those who don't have access to internet or anything, they can always look up for this, right? So with the application,
the first going on, we have to do the registration with the username, and the threshold value is the value like the compass value. Like when you exceed this value, you will be started with communicating with the device, the sensor device. It will show like I'm just going to switch on the device now. Right, so I'm going to register it. I've registered it, and it's showing this device. So this is where I get my data. I've just updated my data right away, and the server, you can see the updated data. And the humidity value right now, and altitude is, and longitude and latitude, it's this DLS latitude and longitude. And we move ahead.
Direction, facing, and temperature
is 27 degrees. This is all live values, what you have just got from the meter. I have uploaded within a second to my server. And now,
and this happens on activity. So if there is an activity on the device, it's completely registered with the device when it is away from the device's threshold value. So what do we mean by threshold value is that each user has a preference. So if he chooses that after something like 30 kilometers, he wants the device to switch on and try to send all the necessary data about his trekking or his travel mission along the way into the main database, he can do so. So this is completely on the user's choice. But what we would actually extend this to children also, where parents do want to have a control over where their children are going, or at least know if they are safe or not. So these values would not mean any sense if this device was used singly, but since it would go through an Android device into the service and then go to somewhere else with this device that we have, we would have meaningful sense of what this information actually means. So, sorry we had to dismantle this because it was part of our apparatus near the laptop. But I'll just give a brief explanation of what this is. This is an Arduino board. It's along with a dedicated BizNet chip that performs the Ethernet capability. So what we have here is an IoT, Internet of Things device. So when the internet will be connected to this device will have a polling mechanism where it will try to reach out to the server and try to find out what this particular device, like if somebody's son or daughter is having this device with them. So all these necessary data, especially the distance from the start and the temperature. So these are the two things that we feel that are important for a parent to know about a child or some tracker to know about a particular location. So these are two things that are very important. So they can track
these two are the things which we don't get from a smartphone basically.
Yes. And why we went for such a device was that because these are very, very low power devices. So when you have BLE devices, these devices can run for almost like 5 years with a single charge of the CR32 battery. And they're at throwaway prices. So you don't need to have a costly phone to do this. You just need a normal Android phone and this tab to give you a very comprehensive data set about your tracking machine. So this is what we wanted to achieve. And this is an extension of the data that we have here and use it meaningfully for someone who cares about that person. So this will be at home. This will be with the person who is traveling. So we wanted to create that abstraction. So this is what we've planned for this project. So I think we can also say maybe this project will help towards...
Yeah, so we have this Arduino board connected with
this
LED,
is
multicolor LED here, full color LED basically, 8-bit I believe,
yes.
Right? And what we have is every time there is an update to the server, so this Arduino board is going to poll the server every time and it will get the distance from the start and location, right, current location. By that we can actually calculate how far he is from his central location, which will be marked the first time he starts using it, right? So from that central location, if the threshold value is say 30 kilometers, if he starts moving outside, so then until 30 kilometers, this light will glow green. And if he starts moving outside, it slowly starts to move into orange. And so calculation that we have right now is, if he reaches 60, probably what I'm saying is, if he reaches 200% of the threshold, it turns completely red, which means he is way outside the moment, right? So that's the logic that we have right now. What we were planning was have some sort of an external display that will take this distance and take the location, plot it on a map view.
So this is the interest of time. Do you have any questions? So what other sensors do you think will add value to this?
Right. So one thing that we haven't used yet is gyroscope. So you saw something like direction facing, right? So direction facing is something right now we've tried to calculate based on what the data is given by the device. We weren't able to, so right now it's always
smartphone, basically.
Yeah, from the smartphone, the tablet, but we weren't able to complete it. So right now it shows north all the time. But ideally using the magnetometer and the gyroscope, by using sensor fusion, we should be able to identify the bearing, which direction is moving. So any person who is looking at that information will know which direction he's going. So he'll know whether he's coming in or he's going out, because this update is going to be every, not frequent.
Any other questions? No. Okay. Thanks, guys.
Looks
like a very interesting hack with lots
of
devices.
Thank you. Thanks, all.
Who wants to go next?